Hello everyone and welcome back to Spellweaver, where today I'm going to be doing a deck tech. But first things first, sorry about not doing a video for quite some time. Sorry, don't hurt me. But I'm doing one now, so that's good. And I'll be doing another one in a few days' time. So, yay, maybe, hopefully. Anyway, today, deck tech time, we'll be showing you a deck which uses one of the new heroes. Oh yeah, since I last did a video, new heroes have come out. There are now six. There are... Why did I do that? Hermeleon. Alric. Kiano, which we'll be doing a deck on today. Burke. Unfortunate name. Cronus. And Enoch. And at the moment, it would appear that Kiano is the most overpowered thing ever. That might not be true, but it is. So we're doing a deck tech on her today. We're doing a deck tech on a week in a few days' time. But today's deck, I will show you. It is very sexy. Filled with everything. Just look at it. Like six colours. That's what we're playing. We're playing a six-colour reanimator deck. And it works, and it might be the best deck. I don't know yet, but it's doing bloody well. It was created by our very own Rotzbengel, who was known as Thiegel in this game. Rotzbengel slash Thiegel was the most insane deck builder in Scrolls. I mean, I like to think I was quite good at deck building. I was like focused on a collection. Imagine my focus on 80% of what could be done and made that really good. But he was went wild on many things and just tested some weird, wacky stuff and came up with quite a few funky things. And he came up with the concept of this deck. And together we've been working on it for a few weeks now. And as I said, it's insane. Oh yeah, I should mention, the Badger Guild, which was the top guild in, well, top guild group, whatever you want to call it, in Scrolls, has reformed. And we're now taking on Spellweaver. We've got all the best ex-Scrolls players in the guild as well now. We've got a Spellweaver team, so we're going to try and dominate Spellweaver as well. We've got Smogan, I made him in charge of Spellweaver for the group, so that's good. Sisp, he's playing as well. We've got Thiegel, Rotzbengel, if you know him. Dialex, Lahopa, Puku, myself, and Spiffy Drew. That's our little group, and we've come up with a few things. So this is one of the decks we've come up with. I'll be showing you another one later on, as I said. But let's get into this one. So, Reanimator is the name of the deck, Kiano Reanimator. It uses this card, Reanimate, which says put a creature card from your graveyard on the field. So the idea is we get stuff in our graveyard, then we reanimate it, and we just get early big creatures out, and it's just unfair. So let me show you what Kiano does first of all. It has a 1 nature level 1, what should we call it? Mono? Is that a bad way of saying it? One non-colour level as well. And it costs 2 mana, and it has a cooldown of 2. It says, play a creature with cost 3 or less from your hand under Kiano without paying its cost. At the start of your next turn, put it on the field with a Might Emblem on it. So not only can we play creatures 1 or 2 turns earlier than we normally might, it also comes on the field with +1/+1, which is really useful. So if we put a Library Guard under Kiano, it comes out as a 3/4. Spirits will be 2/2. Airship Explorer, 2/6, you get the idea. So we use this to get down Airship Explorers early. Airship Explorer allows us to draw a card and we discard a card. We discard things like Red Dragon, Lord Karthas, and then we reanimate it. That's the general plan. And it's insane. So, 2 Antrial. We've got how many things of this deck? We've got about 8, I think. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, we've got 8 massive creatures. So these are the targets that we have to reanimate. 2 Antshell, which is an order creature. As I said, playing 6 colours. It's a 6/6 for 4, 4 levels, but we're not interested in the number of levels. We'll never be able to hardcast this because we haven't got the shines. So Antshell, Pitch for Sunblessed. It's got Flying, Lifebound. Lifebound is like Lifelink from Magic the Gathering. Other creatures you control are Lifebound. So whenever we deal any damage, we gain life. And gaining life is bloody good. So, and also the 6/6 body is really hard to deal with because any instant damage or any damage spells like was it Dragonfire deals 5 damage and 6 damage is more. So very struggling to deal with that. And the healing is insane, especially against aggro decks. And it can be quite good against control decks as well. Because sometimes the decks just, the games just stall and you gain life instead of, whilst not being able to deal damage to them, you gain life at a greater rate. Usually wins you the game. We've got one red dragon. So you didn't necessarily need red dragon in this deck. Or Ziara. But I wanted to go six colours. And it's more of a sort of flavour thing because it's just awesome. And one red dragon doesn't hurt. There's, since the Lord Karthas and Ancho, which are the best, are legendary. You can't get more than one of them on the field, so you want a few more targets and big targets. So one red dragon helps. You can also just play it from a reanimate and like target opponent's face twice for 10 damage, and that works quite well. And it also just, it's a big flying 3-speed 5/5. So what's wrong with that? Then Ziara, again. Although I'm running reanimate, it's not really needed in the deck. But it's more of a flavour thing, running all the big creatures in the game. -1/-1 is really good against aggro decks. You reanimate it against all these little goblins and elves, and then they just lose. And it can get really big. And combined with Ant Shell, you can just do an insane amount of damage and gain you lots of life. Then we've got Lord Karthas, which is the main creature, which you want because it destroys things. It has been nerfed since the last video I did. It doesn't just gain you life whenever anything dies, it's only when it kills something. So you can still gain a bit of life, but it's mainly its ability to destroy things, which is what you want Lord Karthas for. Then we've got targets for Keanu's ability. We've got four Discriminative Spirits and four Library Guards. So these draws cards. Drawing cards is good, and they can get quite big. Spirit, play it on turn two. Turn one if you're desperate. I've never done that before, but just to cycle through your deck to help find things. Library Guards as well. It's a big body, really good speed. You play that turn two, thanks to things like New Horizons and Keanu. So that's really useful. 3-4 body, just rage can't do anything about it. Unless they like, have to use like two cards, and that's just beneficial for you, so that's good. Edge of Explorer, as I said, is in this deck to put things in your graveyard. It could be a 2/6, thanks to Keanu, which, you know, your opponent just won't be able to deal with. And if they do, they have to put a lot of resources in to be able to deal with it. And you don't really care too much, because we have other ways of playing creatures for, without using shrines. If that makes sense. Playing levels and stuff. I'll show you that in a second. But Airship Explorer is one of our ways of getting creatures in the graveyard, so we can reanimate them. Also a really good body. We've got three Jenna Wishes. This was a late addition to the deck. Originally, we were trying out Dryala, which was working well. But I kept on finding that ran out of cards in hand very, very quickly. So then I noticed Jin only had one wisdom level, which is insane because it just draws you lots of cards. Draws you spells and artifacts, so you can draw Airship Explorers from it and one of your 11 spells. So it just keeps your hand full and helps you find reanimates, New Horizons, whatever you want to draw at the time. Then we've got two Unicorns. This deck was weak against Lamp until I added these, and now it does well. Because Lamp could just wreck for you. I don't know why it's got 3-speed, it should have 2. But Unicorn helps us deal with that. Can reanimate it if we're desperate, which sometimes you are, so it's always useful. Sunchasing Aurite is an interesting creature, and might be like the best creature in the game right now, if I could say that. It's just a massive 4/4 body for 3, which you can play early on with Keanu here. Make it a 5/5. It can increase its speed by 2, so it struggles to get blocked and get in for damage, just snipe off anything. It's a really, really solid creature, which for a 4/4 for 3, really good. A 5/5 for 2, which effectively is with Keanu, is insane, which we can get to 4 speed. You know, it's just really, really good. Took me by surprise when I found this in the deck, so that's useful. Then the spells, we've got 3 New Horizons. That helps us find the shrines we want so we can play all our stuff. 4 reanimate. Put a creature from my graveyard on the field. And then the star of the deck. Overwhelming Forces. It's a 5 mana, 2 level, one of Aspeed Dominion. Spell. Look at the top X cards of your deck, where X is the number of creatures of the hero who has the most creatures. Put any number of creatures from them on the field and rest on the shuffled on the bottom of your deck. So the idea is your opponent's got like 4, well, you or your opponent have like 4 or 5 creatures on the field. You play Overwhelming Forces, it helps you find your big stuff. So you can find Lord Karthas, Red Dragon, Ziara, or Antriel, which otherwise you wouldn't be able to cast because you haven't got the shrines. And it's just a huge swing in the game and can win. I mean, I had an overwhelming forces turn, whatever it was, the fantasy area, right to my opponent's board, because it was filled with lots of little goblins, and it just went up to like 11 attack. It was ridiculous. So Ziara works well. Overwhelming forces gets you things you need. And we've got shrines, 8 wisdom, 7 nature, 3 dominion, and 2 corruption. It's difficult to find the right balance, but this has been performing well. I do want to go up to like a third corruption shrine, but I'm not really sure what to drop. Why change what something that is broken? What have you say that? I can't really speak at the moment. So that's the deck. Are you playing some ranked with it? Maybe just one game, because it's a control deck, so games can last a while, depends who we're facing. And yeah, I'll show you how it goes. Okay then, so we're playing against PewQ, who is playing exactly the same deck as I am. So this can only go well. This is a really poor hand. We've got a few big creatures, which, although good, we don't really want them, especially these. Perez be back in the deck for overwhelming forces. We haven't got any new horizons. And the shrines are a bit dodgy, so we're going to try and find a better hand. This is a lot better. There's no new horizons to ramp us up, but we've got a few creatures which we can just play early on. So as long as he doesn't have too much of an explosive start, because he has got the spark as well, so he can use that on his first turn to play New Horizons, which usually PewQ has because he's PewQ. No? Okay. So we're going to sack the Wisdom Shrine, because we've already got one Wisdom level, and we'll just play the Spirit. So we're going to look to get Airship Explorer going soon, get a few things in our graveyard, and then look to reanimate them. We're going to need to try and find a Corruption Shrine. So maybe drawing New Horizons might be good. Library Guard, so he's going to have a 3-4, which draws him a card. Well, I can respond with an Airship Explorer. Might have been better off going with the Spirit and then getting out the Djinn instead. But at least getting out of the Airship Explorer, especially with a reanimating hand, can get me going. That's not too bad. I'm just getting 2 spirits out, doesn't really get me anywhere. Nice to get the Djinn working there. Let's see what he has to respond. He's already got a really strong creature out. He'll be searching for a Corruption Shrine, I think, next turn. So send back a Nature Shrine. Hope to find a Corruption Shrine. Don't get one. So we'll just go for some resources. Spirit. Okay. I guess we have no other play, so we'll just pass. Next time we can play Vision. Might just hard cast it to get the draw. Best thing would be to set the Airship Explorer, find Karthas, and then find a Corruption Shrine. It'd be hard, but I can do it. I mean, reanimating is sort of more for the late game stages that I'm looking to play it, but if I can get it going early, then great. Especially with what's in this deck, it might be wasted just on a 3-4. So overwhelming forces might be the better route to go down. Yeah, we're just going to draw some cards here. Don't find anything? We don't need shrines. We've got plenty in hand, so we'll just get rid of that. Get a unicorn, so that'd be good to get rid of his Airship Explorers. Let's see if we can find a Corruption Shrine. There's a shrine still, okay. So we can go for another level here, but I think that'll be wasted. I think we might be better off using the ability and playing a spirit. We get our overwhelming force as well, so that'd be good. So I can go Dominion Shrine next turn, play Djinn, and then look to overwhelming forces, so that'd be quite good. So you go to this and put Airship Explorer underneath. And play Spirit. And pass for go. I'm still a bit torn over Unicorn, over whatever it is, for 2-1 wisdom thing. Not so sure it's the right way to go, but it's fine, I guess. The speed's handy. Especially used with this, because it can actually take down a... lamp. Yeah, we'll just block here. See what we find. Nothing, we get Corruption Shrine there, that's excellent. I don't really want to get rid of any of these shrines. So I think we're just going to... Oh, this is going to be... This is tough. Unicorn just to get rid of... I suppose I can reanimate unicorns, can't I? So I'll get rid of that. I think I should have waited. Maybe a bit hasty there. That would have been the smarter thing to do, wait. I was scared somehow I'll kill it with a unicorn of his own, so... Not too bad, I guess. So we're going to Overwhelming Forces in a couple of turns. So we'll go with Dominion Shrine this turn. Do I just Library Guard? Or do I play Vajin? I'm scared he'll just kill Vajin. He's got nothing in his hand. Nothing in his graveyard either. I think we'll just go Jinvan. And look to draw off it. We miss. That way... If I shuffle stuff back in my deck, I can get the deck shuffled. If I put something, it'll go to the bottom of my deck and then I can shuffle my deck this way, so this is fine. So hopefully we can get a good Overwhelming Forces next turn. We might have 5 or 6 creatures. Maybe even 7. And maybe get a few Karthases. 1 Karthas, a red dragon would be nice. Right. Might actually wait until Antrio's out to do that. I don't know if I should block for damage or trade. I think I just want to take the damage here. But I don't want to kill that because it's another card for my Overwhelming Forces to use. Actually, I think I've got 2 Overwhelming Forces hand. I may as well go for 1 here and I could always play it afterwards to get... When if he resummons Antrio, which he might be struggling because he's only got he hasn't got the Corruption Shrine yet. If I get Ziara back, that'd be quite good, just wipe his board. Let's see what we can find. Airship Explorer, I don't need any more of them. Lord Karthas, okay, that'd be good to reanimate, so we'll put that in the graveyard. Let's send that back. Get a... Oh, that's a non-corruption shrine, but that's fine. So we'll Overwhelming Forces. There we get 2 Sun Chasers. I've had worse. Should have done that first, actually. New Horizons? Okay, that's a bit useless now because the Corruption Shrine is in my hand. I can always use it to block. We'll go full speed now. This way I can actually respond to him attacking instead of him attacking, then things change, because that's just awkward. There's no actual point before the attack step where you can activate abilities, which is a bit annoying. So hopefully he can't Overwhelming Forces in response, because that would suck. So options are to just reanimate Lord Karthas next turn. And New Horizons, I put Corruption Shrine back in my deck. Or just go full Overwhelming Forces and sort of open up that play. He's not really going anywhere at the moment, is he? He's sort of trying to set up, so... He might be struggling to find the right shrines. I'm scared if I just get a massive board, he'll Overwhelming Forces back. But I've got reanimate so I can reply, so we'll just may as well keep going. Airship Explorer again, okay. Definitely want to target these Airship Explorers. So if I can get a Unicorn. Let's see what we can get. New Horizons, don't need that. And you can just get rid of New Horizons, no point. Okay, so Overwing Forces, number two. Okay, Red Dragon, Library Guard, and Spirit. Still not brilliant. There's my Tiara. Okay, so I can discard and reanimate Bannix to just kill things. I can kill Library Guards here. Might as well draw, see what we get. We get another Overwhelming Forces, so we can Overwhelming Forces again. This time, however, it'd be my board that's big, not his. I think I'd rather wait on attacking here. Well, no, might as well kill him off. We don't need to play the Corruption Shrine until next turn. So we'll take out these. So we've got three Lord Karthases in deck, two Antrails. We've got Lord Karthas in the graveyard. So there's a decent chance of hitting something quite powerful. The deck is very small though. I've been tempted to add in one copy of that demon which mills a player, but then you can pay mana to put creatures back in the deck. Just so I just don't mill myself. He's really trying to filter through his deck here. Yeah, he's trying to set up Okay, well, I want to try and reduce the number of creatures on my side of the board as well. Just in case he tries to overwhelming forces. Seven targets is still pretty good. This is such a weird game. Kind of stops me doing the Ziara play, so I might not go with that. I just want to kill these, so... Red Dragon Reanimator Unicorn might be your play. Or I could just... if I knew he wasn't running everyone forces, I would just play another one and just destroy everything. It could be such a huge swing. Actually, no, you can only play one Lord Karthas, can't you? It destroys one creature. So I might as well just play another one. A weird lag spike there. And another one. Stop doing that. Overwhelming Forces, here we go. Let's see what happens. He's going to get seven cards to look at, and... He gets a Lord Karthas, so he destroys my Red Dragon. Weird lag spikes, okay. Obviously too much for it to handle. So, guess Overwhelming Force moment. We will put Ziara back in the deck. Shuffle said deck. Overwhelming Force. Let's see what we get. Hitting a Unicorn would be nice. Okay, so get Anshul, that, and that. That's good. He's adding these, that's good. Okay. Okay. Get a Unicorn. Can play the Unicorn, I guess? Or I could just use my hero ability and get a Library Guard. I think I will Unicorn just to kill a few things. What's attacking? This is a quick, easy word to tell. They are... I don't care if he blocks these with them because... Whatever. I do care if he blocks these a bit. I'd rather he do that than attacks into here, so I might as well just get the damage through. And also reduces his chance of overwhelming forces, so... What was his attack for damage? We get a bit of healing as well. Yeah, simple block, but I get the heal. And Unicorn. Now he can attack here to kill the Unicorn, so we'll move Unicorn back. Attack with these into this. If I can block, that's fine. It's when he overwhelming forces me now that I'm scared. I can reanimate Red Dragon though and blow something up. And his best Lord Karthas target would be Ancho, wouldn't it? I've got to use its ability. So I've got two reanimates in my deck still. I've got two Lord Karthas, another Antriel, and Ziara. Another Jhin as well. Another Overwhelming Forces. One, two, how many shrines have I got through? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, something like 11. What is that? 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So there's 8 shrines. And a few big things. He's going to reanimate plan, so he hasn't got overwhelming forces in hand. That's good. So I feel a double reanimate turn coming out. Reanimate Anshul and Lord Karthas. I might just reanimate Red Dragon, actually. You know, I want my heals. Healing's probably how I'm going to win this game. Let's see if we can find an overwhelming forces for my Jhin. We got something. New Horizons. That's a bit bad. Get overwhelming forces. There it is again. Okay, so we're gonna play a creature here. I don't want this to be one that draws me a card. So, oh no, we'll just play Lyra Guard. See what we guess. We'll just put it back in my deck. Okay, so overwhelming forces. Don't want to use Lord Karthas. Everything. Okay, so let's draw a card. I'll be decking myself here. That's not good. Reanimate, that's good. Right, so let's see how this all works out. We have the option to attack here, the option to attack there, and we can also just attack this, but he can reanimate it, which I don't want it to do. So I think we're just going to go face here. I know he'll just block here, probably. I'm not too bothered. I'd rather it stay on the field. It's not doing much. It's just all about gaining life. Or are you trying to get him down so I can set up a Red Dragon win? I think I don't want to draw any more cards ever. My deck is getting small. So I heal for 7, so I'm up to 38. Two things die, so this goes up to 6. Possibly should have attacked first when I could have got Lord Karthas from my overwhelming forces. I was scared things were going to die. Since you've got a much value. It's a 40 in fact. Excellent. That went well. We'll move the unicorn up. Down. Whatever. We'll just leave it there. Just want to gain life. So his only chance really is if he manages to get an overwhelming forces and does something horrible. He gets the overwhelming forces for 11. Whatever he does, I can reanimate twice next turn. If he finds Lord Karthas, he has two options for which to kill, Ziara or Antriel. I'd rather he kills Antriel, because then I can reanimate it and Lord Karthas is going to be huge. I mean, Ziara will be huge. Oh my god! That's a board. that's a lot. So reanimates Lord Karthas to destroy this so he doesn't gain life. I attack and gain the life and win. Is that how it's gonna work? This is crazy. I'm sorry about the lag spikes in this video, by the way. This is the reason why I haven't been doing any videos, because I don't know why this happens, but I've been getting awful lag spikes. This has been spoiling things. So this could be game. We just need to gain 10 life, and we've got more than enough damage here. I think he might just surrender. No? Okay. Don't want to draw cards. Up to 42. So I have to play. How many reanimates should I play? I'll just go just for one, I guess. I could go get a unicorn back. I would have to get Lord Karthas back. Destroy Antriel. Attack face of everything. Which will gain me enough life to win. That was an incredible game. That was crazy. But that just shows you what this deck's capable of, but I guess you'll never hopefully face anything like this as a mirror match, because that'd be weird. You reach 50 more life. I haven't actually got the win comp for this deck by getting to 50 life. That's quite rare. But there you go. That's Keanu Reanimator. I'll just go over the deck one more time. If I can find it. There we go. So it's 2 Antriel, Patron of the Sunblessed, 4 Disquisitive Spirits, 3 New Horizons, 4 Library Guards, 4 Airship Explorer, 3 Djinn of Wishes. Our hero is Keanu Edge of the Spear. We've got 2 Venerated Unicorns, 4 Sunchaser Aurites, 1 Red Dragon, 4 Overwhelming Forces, 4 Lord Karthas Death Speakers, 4 Reanimates, 1 Ziara Sovereign of Souls, and then we've got a number of Wisdom Shrines. How many? It was 8, I think. 7 or 8? 1, 2, 3. Oh, God, I've forgotten. Sorry, forgotten. 8 Wisdom Shrines. 8 Wisdom Shrines, 7 Nature Shrines, 3 Dominion Shrines, and 2 Corruption Shrines. That is it. So, I hope you enjoy playing the deck, and you stick with it, because it is really fun. It's the only 6-colour deck in the game. So, there you have it. So, thanks for watching, and I will see you next time. Goodbye.